The family started point of view in historical science that the first towns in Siberia appeared in the 16th century when the Russians entered the region. Now, however, a number of scientists suggest that the towns as center of political and economic life on the ancient population had existed before the Russians arrived. Of course, they were not large as the population density in Siberia has traditionally been low. However, many other features of the town, in particular the presence of crafts, trade, government, items of military equipment, and therefore military science specialization, elements of urban development. The presence of fortifications are present in the material culture of the population of the forest-steppe Trans-Urals zone since the late Bronze Age. The main localization area hill forts in the Trans-Urals in the forest-steppe belt. It is a contact zone between the taiga and steppe. The north climate change led to the migration of the population which penetrated into the steppe from the north and the south in different periods of time. As a result, social tensions emerged in the zone, but innovations brought by the new population sprang up more often. The first hill forts in the forest-steppe Trans-Urals date back to the end of the Bronze Age, at the turn of the 10th-9th century BC. They emerged in related of the climate change where water level rose in the rivers. A consequence, the taiga population migrated to the south. The migrants met local population in the forest-steppe zone. As a consequence, there were social tendencies which led to construction of fortified settlements on such natural protected area as high capes of bedrock river terraces. There were few of them in the late Bronze Age, not more than six. The fortifications served for defense against dangers. The fortifications were primitive, fragile, they consisted of a ditch and a fence. Hill forts with a circle pattern got widespread at the time of transition from the Bronze Age to the early Iron Age. The buildings within there are orderly planned. The fortifications are seemingly fragile, they are presented by a low rampart and the ditch round in shape. The fortifications are reconstructed as wooden fences with a trench or a ditch at the base. Economic development and cattle breeding in the early Iron Age make the beginning of social stratification of the population. Rise in number of hill forts dates back to that time. Population of the Baitova, the Gorokhova, and the Sargat cultures lived in the territory of the forest-steppe Trans-Urals in the early Iron Age. The number of hill forts is roughly equal 18-25 in each culture. Thus, hegemony of any of the groups of population did not exist. Mixed population lived in another around 30 hill forts. This fact gives evidence of contacts and assimilation among the ancient population. During the period, the evolution of the structure of fortification can be clearly traced. A series of analyses using GIS showed that the leading factor in the location of hill forts was the factor of safety and relief suitability for making fortifications and the factor of ecological capacity of the territory. Available of nature resources. The main function of the hill forts was to preserve the life and the property. Communications analysis showed that the population of the hill forts could signal other hill forts about an impending danger. We believe that certain hill forts transformed gradually into political and economic center in course of time. Populations of the Baitova culture lived in the territory of the forest-steppe Trans-Urals at the beginning of the early Iron Age, 6-4 centuries BC. Slightly fortified fortresses were built at an early stage of its existence. The hill forts were fenced about with palisades set on a low rampart. The soil for the rampart was taken from the ditch at its base. In addition to ordinary economic activities, such as pottery, hide and wood processing, and metalworking crafts for starting up in the hill forts. It is proved by melting pots, abrasives, nozzles, molds, slugs, etc. found there. At the time the steppe population evaded from the source, the Sargat community was formed. The type of economy change, cattle breeding, began to develop, social stratification appeared. The density of population in the forest increased greatly. Power of fortifications of the Baitova culture increased. More power ramparts and ditches fortified with wooden palisades and fences atop. Gate towers appeared. In general, the main elements of fortification structure were preserved, but the parameters were 2-3 times amplified. Later, in the 1st centuries AD, representatives of the Gorokhova and the Sargat culture became the main population of the forested Trans-Urals. They had connection with the Ural region, with the Sakha steppe fold, ties with China and the Black Sea region. The area of hill forts increased in the period of time. Fortification of innovate forms appeared. Round and cusp hill forts were fences with 2-3-4 defense lines of different complexity. Later, defense appeared. The slopes in the settlements were escarped. Fortification consists of various combination of lines of ramparts and ditches and ground and wooden construction of them. Existing options such as palisades, fences were supplemented by wall in mortise and tenon technique offense. Gates appeared in the body structure of the rampart, the ditches were lined with wood. Among innovations, there were fortified gate towers. Complex entrances, defense lines got offset. Those offset are interpreted as a prototype of a bastion tower. Probably those traditions had been brought from the source, from the Sakha and the Sarmat tribes. Recorded evidence of crafts, blacksmiths and metalworking, trade center, ancient ceramics, imported items, bed, necklaces, jewelry, tissues in the material culture of the population date back to that time. Many of the artifacts were found in the hill forts and at the newly located mounds. The population was clear, stratified, we can distinguish and elite paramilitary upper class of society, a strata of ordinary soldiers and ordinary citizens. Some hill forts had an ordered plan with the elite building standing out. Perhaps the dwelling of the nobility, the noblemen's armed forces. There are about 40 fortresses of this period in the steppe Trans-Urals area known to us, but only 5-6 hill forts have signs of major social and political centers. Rafailova, Kolova, Pavlinova, Batakova, Chudaki, Marina, Goch. They are the hill forts with traces of crafts in the citadel with an ordered housed system. Present of elite dwellings, evidence of international trade exchange. Outside of the fortifications, there were unfortified village. Later, the process of urbanization was influenced by the migration period in the territory at the turn of the century. Trade ties were cut. A large part of the population went to the west with the conquerors. Thus, we can trace the emergence of hill forts and their transformation into protocities based on the materials of fortresses of the forested Trans-Urals area. They appeared in the late Bronze Age, their number increased the early Iron Age. In the same period, there were a great variety of forms and schemes of fortifications. There was a search for optimal solution. Major social and economic centers stood out. The main factor which influenced the emergence and development of proto-cities are the following. The climate factor and the migration factor related to it in the late Bronze Age. The economic factor, social stratification, and the potestary factor, the factor of power in the early Iron Age. Thank you for attention.